its adversary, the MiG-15, because this is very much the aircraft that was in service in various variants, F-35 Lightning II. The other interesting connection between this aircraft and the Korean combat zone of the MiG was the Saturday engineer here. And then developed through a whole range of operations. The Japanese air self defense and the German Air Force as well. Keeping the service around the world and not being retired until the Bolivian Air Force finished use of this aircraft as recently as July 2017 after an incredible 44 years of service. Flight in 1948 was in the hands of Tony Revere, with Canadians from the 1950s right through until 2005. And this one, the result of a 1951 contract to build the shooting star trainers for the RCAF. Canadians use them in communication, target towing, and enemy simulation work. Final one was retired from the aerospace test establishment at Canadian Forces Base Cold Lake and used and as injection seat to test bays after an amazing 46 years of service. Shepherd Air Force Base in the USA, as well as attending various academy and country college courses in the US, and became a graduate of the Shepherd Training Establishment.
Representing the Royal Navy Shark helicopter
still playing by one of the world leaders, most famous test pilots, indeed the country of UK. Transitioning as they fly there, keeping a stable profile of the easiest of maneuvers when you're in formation. Tremendous that so many people have been investing. It is thanks to the investors, of course, that we have these aircraft and a magnificent sight this is. And an extraordinary aircraft produced during the World War II era. Designed around that huge R2800 double WASP engine. I find aircraft with just one WASP, that's pretty easy, I can assure you. But yeah, a lot of alongside the United States Army Air Force as well. An incredible 15,636 of these aircraft were produced between 41 and 45. Absolutely astonishing reputation and much love to find in the time. It was built in 1945 at Republic's Evansville factory in Indiana. Looking here at the 47D, the open service did serve with the air training command during the last few months of the war and eventually saw the Tinker Air Force Base in Oklahoma. Didn't get restored to full operational status until 1952. Air Force did good service right through until 1967, initially as a frontline fighter. He'll be looking down now as he comes by out of his canopy to see you. Come on, boys and girls, mums and dads, give John and this fabulous P-47 Thunderbolt a great way home. Well done, superb display.
it in the big way to complete the second memorial patch.
Both sides.
The others are coming in from the right.
Thank you.
right up there in terms of strength as well, particularly in your arms and in your neck. Coupling through the sky there, and of course very busy in the cockpit as well, with the stick and the pilot getting all over the place as he does his best to go into these maneuvers and then of course rapidly recover from them. It's pretty standard in a lot of flying training, of course, to put aircraft into unusual maneuvers because you can be trained all the time to recover from them if you inadvertently enter such a thing. He's got all sorts of favourites here. His power of power will be coming up with the station. High angles of attack as well, that's his trademark sort of flying. Slightly improved engine, a modified Locomi 0540 as well. Giving an extra 20 horsepower compared to the red butterfly biplane that you would normally be seeing in. Again, like so many. Coming up 300 miles an hour or so, and he's going to pull up. Here, he's going to very shortly his stomach muscle and his legs to try and stop the blood running into his feet. Checking out, putting it into a few extra rolls there, and creating what we call a long trabec, or a check of the back. Letting it drift back through its smoke and then tumbling. All under control though at the same time.
Looking at the focus for questions. As you see there, the aircraft is being disposed, showing the main road. Main road head,
It carries at the moment in the latter stage of development is the future anti-surface guided weapon, the Mark Slip, which can
Goes for
a
healing
out. Slightly longer range.
Shooting another wing over. Thank you. As the entry positions now once more at the right side. He's going to run into the ground and break out of the V-axis, which is 90 degrees to the axis he's on now. He's going to run away from the ground, set us for a high G turn.
Thank you.
will pass. Please welcome the Strikemaster pair.
Goes into a slow and dirty loop.